Welcome to Global Technology 5173. Where are we now? What time is it now? Fall 2013. And believe it or not, we are coming to the end of our semester. It has been a wonderful semester, I hope. And today is no less, even maybe the best day in the class. Now, this is your day. How about that? This is your day. When I point at you, say big shine. This is your day.
Shine.
Excellent.
Before telling why we chosen this topic, we'd like to, from the last class, if you have remember, we spoke about the future technologies. Then we all sat together. We have come up to this topic because this is a future technology, I believe. As Brad has already thrown a light on nanotechnology, I has been interested in nanotechnology from the engineering days, and now I want to give a full-fledged presentation on carbon nanotubes. This is the building blocks of the future technology. Myself, Sunny, here's Raghu, Tejas, Pramod, and here's Mohini. So our presentation overview, starting with the introduction to nanotechnology. Why we chose the carbon nanotubes and what is special in them. History about the carbon nanotubes, the classification, the development, the properties, applications, and the conclusion. Right from the word from the word nanotechnology, we get nano. Nano is 10 to the power of 9. To the naked eye, hair follicle is the smallest thing that we can see. But if you want to know how much the nano particle would be, it is 10,000 times smaller than our hair follicle. As I said, nanotechnology is science, engineering, and technology conducted at nano school, which is about 1 to 100 nanometers. I put this animated figure because this is the latest engine that is made with the nanoparticles. It has 15,342 atoms. This parallel shaft speed. Reducer gear is one of the largest nanomechanical devices ever modeled in atomic detail. Let's go to the past. How it all started? On December 29, 1959, a physicist by name Richard Feynman, in his lecture, he was in a meeting while he was talking, he described a process in which scientists would be able to manipulate and control individual atoms and molecules. A compound is made up of atoms and molecules. So he has gone down to the level of atoms, and he talked about this nanoparticle on December 29, that is 1959. He said there's plenty of room at the bottom. That means he went narrowed down to the atoms and spoke about this. Over a decade later, a professor by name Norio Taniguchi, sorry if I pronounce it wrong, coined the term nanotechnology. Until year 1981, with the development of scanning, there were not microscopes. To able to see these nanoparticles. Only in 1981 they discovered this scanning tunneling microscope so that everybody could see the nanoparticle and scientists would work on top of it. So why nanotechnology and why nanoparticles? These nanoparticles are higher, they have the higher strength, they are lighter in weight, they have the increased control of light spectrum, greater chemical reactivity than their large scale counterparts. That is the reason these particles are widely used in almost all the fields of science and technology. What exactly are carbon nanotubes? A new form of carbon made by rolling up a graphite sheet. You know, graphite is made up of carbon to a narrow but long tube closed at both sides by fullerene like end caps. This structure is fullerene. Fullerene is nothing but a molecule of carbons, these are all the carbon molecules. When it is closed by the carbon here, they exist in three different structures. One is spherical, one is elliptical, and one is tubular. Through intentional alteration of their physical and chemical properties, fullerenes exhibit an extremely wide range of interesting and potentially useful properties. Because of their structure and their chemical properties, these have been widely used in all sectors. When I go back to the history of carbon nanotubes, it was first discovered in the year 1991. That is when the carbon nanotubes have been discovered. by as Ligma. Thereby, year by year, there has been the development on top of it, and the research is still going on. And we have into the year 2013. The latest was researchers build a carbon nanotube computer. When I talk about this, I remember of Olympics 2009, where Phelps, the greatest swimmer of all time, wore a swimsuit. It had the nanoparticles in them. Why he wore is like the nanoparticles on the swimsuit repelled the water, and he could swim faster than other competitors. And we also have the sunscreen lotions with the nanoparticles. This is a risk, but there are some risks in nanotechnology. But if you consider the risk, there is also a risk of not developing the nanotechnology, which is the future technology. I go into the classification of carbon nanotubes. There are two types of classifications. One is called single wall carbon nanotubes, as it is self-explanatory. It is composed of a single cylinder of carbon. Single cylinder of carbon. As you see in the figure, it has a single cylinder of carbon. And the next classification is multi-wall carbon nanotubes. It has, again, it's a self-explanatory term, consisting of concentric tubes of cylinders of carbon. Like this. Imagine a straw within a straw. That's how it looks. Three types of nanotubes are possible. Within that, you have three types of, nanotubes. One is zigzag cubes, one is armchair, and one is chiral. Zigzag cubes. If you see this figure, the carbon bonding will run through from the start to the bottom. This is a zigzag. That's why they are named zigzag. The advantages, because of its structure, as I said earlier, because of its structure, it has greatest application compared to all the counterparts. Because of this structure, they conduct the electricity better than the regular metals. When you consider the armchair tubes, they have carbon bonds perpendicular to the length of the tube. As you see again in the figure, this is the length, and it is perpendicular. The carbon bonding is perpendicular to the length of the nanotube. Advantage: they act as semiconductors, which either conduct or don't conduct electricity based on the surrounding environment. That is the advantage. Based on the surrounding environment, they change the behavior. And chiral, it's probably least used. These are decent conductors, but not great. All other tubes are called chiral and behave like semi-metals. Next, I would hand it over to Tejas, who would be speaking about the structure of carbon nanotubes.
Hi, I'm Tejas. I would like to continue with structure of carbon nanotubes after the detailed introduction by Sunny. So, carbon nanotubes exist as a macromolecule of carbon. At higher pressure, nanotubes can merge together, like by trading some sp2 bonds and sp3 bonds, giving great possibility for producing strong, unlimited length wires through high pressure nanotube linking. So we'll watch a small video on this one.
Carbon nanotubes are one carbon material. They were discovered about 10 years ago. A new molecular form of carbon discovered a whole series of new and unexpected physical, mechanical, and chemical properties. These unique properties make nanotubes a key element in nanotechnology. Carbon nanotubes are cylindrical, elongated structures with a diameter of 1 to several tens of nanometers and can be up to several centimeters long. They consist of one or more. Nanotubes, armchair or spike tooth, n equals m, zigzag like, zigzag, m equals 0 or n equals 0, helical, chiral nanotubes. One of the remarkable properties of carbon nanotubes is that and increases with increasing temperature. Nanotubes can be used in the following areas: mechanical applications, heavy-duty fibers, composite materials, and nanocircles. Applications in microelectronics, transistors, nanowires, transparent conductive surfaces, and fuel cells. They create connections between biological neurons and electrical devices in the latest neurocomputer developments. Capillary applications, capsules for active molecules, metals and gas storage.
And
carbon nanotubes can exhibit metallic properties or semiconducting properties. In particular, the semiconducting nanotubes are direct gap semiconductors that exhibit excellent optical properties. And furthermore, nanotubes are only several nanometers in diameter. Communication is a technology of the future, and the key to that technology may be carbon nanotubes with a diameter of just several nanometers. The Kato Group uses customized equipment for this type of research and development, and they are making progress.
The properties of carbon nanotubes, they have general properties, single wall, nanotube absorption properties, transport properties, mechanical properties and reactivity. General properties, single wall nanotube, carbon nanotube diameters fall in the nanometer ranges, and it can be hundreds of macrometers long. They are stable up to 750 degrees Celsius in air and up to 1500 to 1800 degrees Celsius in inert atmosphere, beyond which they are transformed into regular polaritic solids. They have of the mass density of aluminium, while the length of a single wall nanotube carbon nanotube can be macroscopic. The diameter has a molecular dimension. It is an interesting feature. The interesting feature of a single wall nanocarbon tube is that it has very high surface area. Example, single graphene sheet is probably the unique example of the material energetically stable in normal conditions. Single wall nanotube in bundles, but isolated and provided the single wall nanotube have an one end open the real surface area, and it is equal to the single flat graphene. The another property is transport properties. The narrow diameter of a single wall nanotube has a strong influence on its electronic excitations due to its small size compared to the characteristic length scale of low energy electronic excitations. Combined with the particular shape of the electronic bond structure of graphene, carbon nanotubes are ideal quantum wise. These are the mechanical properties. The mechanical properties, while tabular nanomorphology is also observed for the many of two-dimensional solids, carbon nanotubes are unique through the particularly strong three-folded bonding of the curved graphene sheets. This makes carbon nanotubes single-wall nanotubes as well as the multi-wall nanotubes particularly stable against deformations. The tensile strength of a single-wall nanotube is 20 times stronger than the steel, and as actually been measured up to 45 GPa. Then reactivity is one another property of the carbon nanotube. It has a chemical reactivity of graphite, fluorescence and carbon nanotubes exhibits some common features, like any small objects, carbon nanotubes have a large surface which they can interact with their environment. Next application part will be continued by my friend Mohini.
Hello, good evening everyone. Now I'm going to talk about the topic applications in carbon nanotubes. Nanotubes hold the promise of creating novel devices such as carbon-based single electron transistors that significantly smaller than conventional transistors. And nanotubes, excellent strength to weight ratios, creates the potential to build an elevator to the space. For carbon nanotube applications in electronics, sensors, biomedical, in electronics, they are used for to interconnect the quantum wires, diodes, and transistors for computing, and they're used for data storages and preparation of capacitors and also flat panel displays. And in medical, biomedical field, nanoelectrodes for imputation, lab ownership, and vision chip for macular degeneration between cell transplantation. Nanomaterials in drug delivery. Dissolution candidates may be the rate limiting step in absorption process of many drugs. Decreasing the practical size increases the surface area and the dissolution candidates. Alternative water-soluble polymer-based nanoparticles, these are more site-specific and exhibit better controlled release characteristics. What are the health hazards that we face by using nanocarbon tubes? According to the scientists at the National Institute of Standards and Technology, carbon nanotubes shorter than about 200 nanometers readily enter into human lung cells that may increase, similar to the aerosols does, and may pose an increased risk to the health. Carbon nanotubes, along with the majority of nanotechnology, are an unexplored matter, and many of possible health hazards are still unknown.
Yeah, coming to the conclusion, the carbon nanotube represents one of the highlights to emerge from nanotechnology research and development to date. These materials have attracted significant research attention over the past decade due to their potential for breakthrough in a broad range of applications. Because of its extraordinary thermal conductivity, and it has some electrical and mechanical properties through which we can add this as an add-on in some of the, like Sunny said, it's in swimsuit and baseball bats, and even in the golf clubs, it can be used in multi places. So, however, given the novel applications of nanotube, it can be difficult to compare these materials to more conventional macroscopic materials. Furthermore, nanotube do offer the possibility of revolutionary rather than evolutionary developments in many product applications. Many new applications of carbon nanotube are constant being discovered, and many are yet to be discovered. That's a conclusion.